Hey, let it be known, I'm working hard when I ain't on the phone. This ain't a hunt, this ain't a foe. Grind never stopping, I'm keeping it cold. Unlocking the door with the holy key. You supposed to be this close to me, and hopefully you understand G.O.D. Maybe this cold and I'm talking like no degrees. This ain't a fluke, I seen it way before it ever happened. It gave me the view, I had to put in my time. But the TV ain't coming in soon. I couldn't leave it all up to a variant or an experience. You gotta get up and do what it do. So complicated, homie, it's you. Always gonna wait until you in the mood. I've been running, came up gunning. Stop the fretting on your words. It's what you hear, not what you heard. I'ma hang on every verb.
Hello, this is George Edmondson from MotionVFX.com. Today we're looking at mTransition noise. Now onto the tutorial. Once again, this is George Edmondson with MotionVFX.com, and we are checking out mTransition noise. mTransition noise can be located in your transitions. mTransition noise comes packed with 69 different transitions that are all really, really cool, really interesting. That includes 5 custom transitions, which means you're going to have a few custom tools beyond some of the tools that you may have in the other ones, such as our pre-animated. So as you can see here, we've got aura, we have the blur transition, bulge down, left, right, and up. And all I'm doing here is I'm taking my cursor, and as you skim over the different transitions, you can get a real-time preview of what those may look like. And as we scroll down, you can see there are many, many more that are really interesting, including the X-ray. I think those are really cool. So you can have a lot of fun with these in music videos, in hype videos. I think that M music video would be something that this would pair along with really well. Today we're going to be looking at some clips of my son actually playing basketball. So he and I were on vacation and we shot this video playing basketball out of the park. So let's check it out. So to apply this transition, you apply it just like any transition. You can click, pick it up, and drag it in between two clips, as you can see here. And as we move our playhead, we can see kind of what's going on. I'm just using my arrows left and right to get a bit of a preview to see that. Now, if we click our transition, we can go over and you can see in our inspector, we have all of these different parameters that we're going to be able to make changes to so that you can fine tune that as you see fit. Now, I really like the just kind of the default, how everything is. I'm going to turn my strength up a little bit here by moving this slider. And then I think that I'm going to come down. And as you can see here, we've got light leaks and we've got light leaks hue. If you click and drag up, you can actually change the hue of your light leaks, as you see here. So I want to change that to something that's a little bit more in line with the sun there. So we're just going to change that, and it's got that kind of yellowish look going on. As you can see here beneath, you can increase the saturation if you'd like, and then you can increase the value so that you can see that's really, really strong. So let's see how that's looking just with those few changes. Really cool. Now you can see here there are some other light leaks going on. So those leaks are going to all change collectively with your hue. So if you do change the hue there, you notice that was kind of an orange, but now these are purple. As you change these are going to change to essentially the opposite colors. So always keep that in mind. Something that I did notice is you can actually keyframe this if you'd like. So I'm gonna set a keyframe really quickly. I've got my keyframe. Okay, that looks really great. Boom. All right. So I'm going to set a keyframe here at 60. and I'm going to use my right arrow and move that forward. And you can see here that these are purple and blue. I think they look really cool, but I do want to maybe make that a little bit more in line with my video. So there we go, something like that, nice and yellow. Let's continue to use our arrows to move forward. And boom, I think that looks awesome. And now we have those colors where we want them by simply using keyframes. So you can also, of course, just use it how it's set if you don't mind the colors. But if you did want to change those colors, set a simple keyframe and you are good to go. All right, let's continue moving down to this next clip. So as you can see here, he is kind of looking to his right there, and then we are walking to the right. So he's still looking to the right. It's just a little bit of a different scene. So I'm going to use my color blur left. Now, the reason I'm using it left is because you can see it's moving to the left, but everything in the scene is kind of going, looking toward the right, if that makes any sense. So if we bring that in, you can see that he's looking to the right. He's on the left side of the screen. And then as we use our arrows, we push forward and boom, there he is in our next scene. Something that will definitely help when you use transitions like this is to always be thinking about the motion that the transition is giving and how that's working with the story of your video. This is really cool looking. I love it. So this one is the color blur left. Again, over in our inspector, you have all of these goodies that you can make changes to as you see fit in your parameters. You notice we have smear. If we toggle that on and off, you can kind of see what's going on. Now that smear is going to be affected with that color as well. If you want to change the opacity a bit, you can. And then we've got our smear color. This red looks really cool, but again, it is kind of a yellow green kind of vibe that we're going for in this video. So I'm just going to change that to that sort of orange there. And then we've got smear color strength. I think I'm going to just bring that strength down the tiniest bit, not much at all. And we can continue to go down. You've got your light rays that you can turn on and off, and that's what's giving that nice bright blown out look, a prism. And if we will actually go back just a bit, you can see that prism, what's going on. If you actually look over here on his head and face, what that prism is doing. And then continue scrolling down, we've got light leaks. We can flip our light leaks if we would like. We can flip those to horizontal, vertical leaks, or both. And then we have our film dirt and our grain. Now, this is called mTransition noise, so there is a lot of grain happening in all of these transitions, which I personally think is really cool looking. Boom, moves over really quick, and then that's just a super quick scene. So the next transition I would like to use is my film blur down. So let's go down here. Now, luckily, this is all in alphabetical order, so it was really easy to find. Film blur down, bring it in between those clips, and check it out. We're kind of using that to represent that there's a big change going. So he goes from walking to dribbling, ball handling, and there's a lot going on in this transition. It's really, really cool. Kind of going back and forth between the two clips a little bit, along with some artifacts that it's throwing in there. So let's click that, check out our inspector. We've got lens distortion strength, and you can see what that's kind of doing there. Our shake strength and footage stretch that you can see there. So if you'd like to kind of warp that, make him make him super tall, there you go. That's how you would do that. We've got our light rays that you can toggle on and off. along with the parameters. I mean, they really opened everything up so that there is absolutely an infinite way that you can use even just one of these transitions. Our light leaks again, film, dirt, grain, and then our marks. So if you like the marks, you can leave them on. If you don't like the marks, you can turn them off. Of course, personally, I love the marks. I think they look awesome. So we're just going to leave those. This next bit, I just had a hard cut here because he's just still kind of dribbling. It's just going from kind of a medium back out to a wide, and then we go into a tight. So on this next one, I just used the film scribble right. So let's go over and we can see here, film scribble right. Let's pick that up, drag it in. Use our arrows and you can kind of see what's going on there. Boom. How sick is that? I love it. All right, over in our inspector, again, just distortion strength, shake, footage stretch, footage desaturation, light rays, our prism again, our light leaks. You can, again, change the value of these light leaks if you would like. So you're going to really colorize that footage to match whatever kind of theme or color grade you might be doing on your footage. Film dirt, grain, and then our scribble that we can turn on and off. But why would you use scribble without it? I love it. And you can change the color of your scribble if you'd like, as well as the position of your scribble. So if you wanted that scribble to be over here on the right side, just simply click and drag on your X parameter there. And then we've got our Y parameter if we wanted to move that up and down. We also have our scribble gradient middle. So for the colorization of your scribble, if you wanted to change that, you can see here over in our blue to sort of reddish pink going on there. We're just moving that middle of that gradient over so that we can get those colors. I wanted to kind of keep with that scribble theme happening for a while. So then I went to the scribble left. Just click and drag it in, and it is the same sort of parameters going on there. So we're moving to the left because we are bringing him in on that right side. Now, this one was interesting. You're going to notice that I'm inside a compound clip. Now, I did this because I was running all handheld on this shot, and inside the compound clip, this is a stabilized clip. Now, if you blade cut a stabilized clip, it's going to restabilize each clip individually, and you're going to have a lot of issues. I did not want that, so I simply put my stabilized clip into a compound clip and then did a blade cut so that I could show you this next way to use these transitions. So this was I just used the film scribble up because again, I was kind of staying on that scribble feel. I'm going to use my arrows and you can see it's going to scribble and go up, but it's the same shot, right? I didn't necessarily want that to happen. I just wanted to kind of put in some scribble and some grain in there just to give it a little bit of life. So over in our inspector, if you notice the footage stretch parameter, I'm going to slide that all the way down. And now, if we go back with our playhead, let's use our arrows. You can see that it's just kind of going to give it a little bit of a shake and that noise and scribble, but our footage essentially stays the same because we're not using that footage stretch. So again, you can use that just to add in some really quick, really interesting effects to your footage to break it up, give it some life. And I think that this would be a really, really useful way of adding a little bit of life to a music video or something like that. Like I mentioned, M Music Video is also available on MotionVFX.com, and I believe the M Transition Noise would be very complimentary to the M Music Video Pack. I then had one more hard cut here, And then we went to the top drone shot of him getting that final shot. And I used one of our custom options. Here I used the custom surge backward because we are going backward. We're going up into the sky. So let's use our custom surge backward. And you notice that you have some on-screen controls. Now you're only going to have these on-screen controls in your custom options. And you can see it right here. And you can see how that is affecting our footage. Now, we kind of lucked out that center just really works well for this. So we're just going to leave it because the focus is on the goal there. But if you wanted to change that position, you do so with your on-screen controls. And you can also do so here in your effect position X and Y parameters over in your inspector. And then again, we have distortion strength, shake, footage scaling, our light rays, prism, leaks, grain, film dirt, and then we have texture. You can just see that that's giving some sort of texture just all around. You can make changes to your opacity if you'd like. Increase those levels in the shadows and highlights if you would like. You can flip your texture, or you could flip it only vertical or only horizontally. Again, there are 69 different transitions in mTransition Noise. This pack is absolutely huge, and we can't wait to see what you can come up with. Again, this is George Edmondson with MotionVFX.com. Be sure to subscribe, and we'll see you on the next one.